speaker is the author of The Battle for Cable Street, Jewish Responses to Fascism in the 1930s. He's also on the National Committee of the Jewish Socialist Group. Please welcome David Rosenberg.
From the Jewish Socialist Group and solidarity with those kept busy week in, week out, tracking the new configurations among our enemies and their new offensives. Just keeping up with who Tommy Robinson's latest friends are is a task in itself. We would have been even busier if Donald Trump had visited this month. Thank you for being part of the reason he didn't. I must credit him, though, with one unwitting achievement. In a world where many want Muslims and Jews to be enemies, Trump's rampant Islamophobia and his open door for anti-Semites have generated beautiful and defiant acts of solidarity between Jews and Muslims. When Trump threatened to create a register of Muslims, thousands of Jews said they would sign that register too. When a Texas mosque burnt down the night after he was elected, a rabbi gave the synagogue keys to the local imam. When Jewish cemeteries were attacked several months ago, a Muslim Palestinian American raised tens of thousands of dollars to pay for the repairs and restoration. Hopeful signs that the unity is spreading. A couple of weeks ago, a synagogue in Leeds was filled with swastikas and the message, "Kikes, go home." The next day, four Muslims representing local organisations brought flowers and messages of condolence to the synagogue, and they were very warmly welcomed. Some of you are too young to know the old anti-Jewish term, kike, but the far right are into retro. It's more than 50 years since anyone in Britain dared to unfurl a banner saying Hitler was right, but that has happened on several occasions in the last 2 years. And that may surprise people who think anti-Semitism is past history, that other victims have replaced them. But racists and fascists don't replace, they accumulate. They switch targets quickly, attack many at once. One moment Muslims are in the front line, another moment it's Roma, it's Poles, it's refugees. And young black men dying at the hands of the police show us that institutional racism persists. But our resistance also persists. And there are only two things that can weaken that. One is a feeling of helplessness, that it's always getting worse. The other is a kind of oppression Olympics, where different groups vie with each other who is the greater victim. We need to challenge both of those mindsets. We must, of course, recognise that the attacks and injustice each group suffers differ in scale, in specifics, in histories. But we must also know that, be clear, that the perpetrators of each are enmeshed in the same system of domination that keeps victims from many communities in fear and keeps the privileged white supremacists at the top. We can only challenge that through unity, unconditional solidarity with all victims of racism, and the confidence that we can and we will win. I know many Jews who fear anti-Semitic attacks. Statistically, they're more likely to be attacked if they were Muslims or recent refugees, but the fear is there. And anti-Semitic attacks are also growing, from verbal abuse to physical assaults on synagogues and individuals. Much of the verbal abuse, when I was younger, used to be about Jews and money. Today it's about Hitler, the Holocaust, and gas ovens. And what is worrying is that this kind of abuse emanates from individuals in a range of communities. Despite the examples I gave earlier, there are also some Jewish people using Islamophobic arguments to stop an Islamic charity establishing itself in Golders Green. Let's not be defensive, but face up to the educational task we all of us have in all of our communities. My final point. Next month, I'll be contributing to that education as one of the group leaders on a trip to Krakow and Auschwitz. organised by Unite Against Fascism. And what I will emphasise there is that Auschwitz was the final destination. But for several years before that, there were processes that too few people noticed and far too many people turned a blind eye to. Scapegoating, discrimination, exclusion, dehumanisation, desensitisation of the perpetrators. This is going on around us, right here, right now, in Britain, in Europe and America. Don't be a bystander, be an upstander for the rights of all. Solidarity.